Hi readers, I'm here to do my wrap-up post for Dewey's 24-hour readathon that took place this last Saturday, April 26th. This is an event that takes place twice a year, once in April and once in October. For those who don't know about it, it's an international reading event. It takes place over a 24-hour period. There were over 800 readers this year, so it was fantastic. Everybody around the world reading together at the same time. I will leave a link below in case you don't know about this event and want to know more. So I hope you'll go down and click that link and check it out and join us in October for the next readathon. We had so much fun. It was just so much fun. I just can't tell you how much fun. I managed to finish two books during the readathon, which is pretty good for me because I get excited, I get distracted, I get really chatty online, and don't spend as much time reading as I think I will. So to have finished two books is really good for me on readathon day. The first one I finished was Show Your Work by Austin Kleon. This is a companion book to Steal Like an Artist. Love both of them, and I will be reviewing them in the near future. They have to do with creativity, the creative process, and in this case, sharing the creative process with other people. I can't say enough good things about it, so I'll save that for the review that I do later, but I do encourage you to read it. The other book I finished was a collection of essays by Joan Didion called Slouching Towards Bethlehem. This works for me as well as the shorter book like I just showed you. Essays work well for me because I can come and go from them. I can pop around. You know, I don't have to have a sustained focus for a really long time. Other people do really well reading longer bits, but for me on readathon day, I do better with shorter works. So this worked really well. I enjoyed this one very much, and I will review this as well. I did work on the novel that I'd started prior to readathon, The Forgotten Garden by Kate Morton. I am enjoying it. I did read some of this during readathon, but I did not finish it and I did not make very much progress with it. But that doesn't have to do with the whether or not I like the book or not, because I am enjoying the book. It just had to do with me and longer works on readathon day. I think there's a couple others of you out there currently reading this book, so maybe we'll get a chance to talk about it together and share our videos with each other. So that is my wrap-up for the Dewey's 24-hour readathon. Again, I encourage you to go down below and check out the readathon and consider joining us in October. See you later. Bye-bye.